Good morning, all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. Today, I am doing my lecture 5 on examples with the solutions of Unit 4. So, we are solving a few examples of Unit number 4, that is magnetic forces and inductances, what we have done. And we are doing a few examples along with solutions. So let us start with first example. A conductor of length 2.5 meter is Z is equal to 0 and X is equal to 4 meter carries a current of 12 amp in minus AY direction. Calculate the uniform flux density in the region if the force on the conductor is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2 Newton in the direction specified by minus AX plus AZ minus AX plus AZ divided by root 2. So this is the numerical first problem. Now there is a conductor, length is 2.5 meter, it is in X equal to 4 and Z is equal to 0. It is carrying a current of 12 ampere in minus AY direction. And we need to calculate the flux density in the region. And the conductor, force on the conductor is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2 Newton. And the direction is minus AX plus AZ divided by root 2. So now we know that the flux B is equal to BX AX plus BY AY plus BZ AZ Tesla, and the force exerted on the conductor, it is given by F is equal to IDL cross B. Now I need to calculate the flux density, that is B value I want. And they have given force on the conductor. Hence, the equation for force on the conductor is F is equal to IDL cross B. Now, let us substitute the value of F. F is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2. In the direction is minus AZ minus AX plus AZ divided by root 2. Is equal to I value, current value is 12 ampere in minus AY direction. So it is minus 12 AY DL. Length of the conductor is 2.5 meter, 2.5. Cross product of B is BX AX plus BY AY plus BZ AZ. Now let us simplify this. That is 12 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by root 2. Simplify this term and I will get it as minus 0.0848 AX plus 0.0848 AZ is equal to, I'll multiply this 12 into 2.5, I'll get minus 30, and I need to find out the cross product of AY cross product of BX AX plus BY AY plus BZ AZ. Now let us multiply, that is cross product we need to find out, and divide this 30, take this 30 to the left side, that is this whole thing divided by 30. Then I will get it as 2.8267 into 10 to the power minus 3 AX minus 2.8267 into 10 to the power minus 3 AZ. That means I have divided this entire thing by minus 30. Now in the right side, I have AY cross AX I'll get minus az, and ay cross ay 0, then ay cross az I will get eax. So after simplifying this step, I'll get minus bx az plus bz ax. Now I need to compare on both the sides. That is, in the left side I have ax. I'll compare this term with bz ax, and I'll compare this term with minus bx az. So the coefficient of az here, it is bx, and the coefficient of ax is bz. So I'll get the value of bx is 2.8267 into 10 to the power minus 3. By value is 0, and bz value I'll get it as 2.8267 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now I need to write the value of b. B is bx ax. I have calculated the value of bx. Bx ax is equal to bz az. So from this equation I will get bx ax and bz az tesla. So the final answer for flux density, uniform flux density, I need to calculate uniform flux density. So flux density is bx, by, bz I need to substitute, then the total value of b is equal to 2.8267 ax plus 2.8267 az milli tesla. So this is the answer for the first question, that is the flux density I have calculated by considering force on the conductor. Second example, a point charge q is equal to minus 60 nanocoulomb is moving with a velocity 6 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second in the direction specified by unit vector minus 0.48 ax minus 0.6 ay plus 0.64 az. Find the magnitude of the force on a moving charge in the magnetic field B is equal to 2 ax minus 6 ay plus 5 az millitesla. So I need to calculate force on a moving charge. So we know the equation force on a moving charge is F is equal to Q into V cross B. That is in magnetic field. Force on a moving charge in magnetic field equation is F is equal to Q V cross B. So to substitute the values, that is Q, V and B, I need to calculate the value of V. B value they have given 2ax minus 6ay plus 5az, and Q value is also given, that is minus 60 nanocoulomb. Now the velocity is 6 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second in the direction specified by the unit vector. So the velocity V is in the direction. Hence I need to calculate the value of V is equal to 6 into 10 to the power 6 into the unit vector. That is minus 48 ax minus 0.6 ay plus 0.64 az meter per second. So this is my actual V. magnitude into direction. I will calculate the value of V. Then I will substitute in the equation. F is equal to Q into V cross B. Now F is equal to Q into V cross B. Q value is minus 60 into 10 to the power minus 9. Nano coulomb they have given. Minus 60 into 10 to the power minus 9 into V cross B. V value we have already calculated using the formula 6 into 10 to the power 6 into minus 48ax minus 0.6ay plus 0.64az. Substitute. And then the value of B is 2ax minus 6ay plus 5az. Since it is in milli Tesla, we will write it as into 10 to the power minus 3. Now multiply the terms. Minus 60 into 10 to the power minus 9, 6 into 10 to the power 6, and 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. And I will get this as minus 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. Then I need to find the cross product of these two, that is V cross B. So I'll write AX, AY, AZ. Then V value is minus 0.48, minus 0.6, then plus 0.64. First row. And second row is 2, minus 6, plus 5. Find out the cross product. Minus 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 as it is. Then cross product, that is AX as it is. This into this, that is minus 0.6 into 5. Minus of minus. Plus 6 into 0.64. First term, simplify, I'll get my 0.84 AX, then minus AY into minus 0.48 into 5 minus 2 into 0.64, I'll get 3.68 AY plus AZ into 2 into minus 0.6. Minus of minus 0.48 into minus 6, I'll get 4.08 AZ. Then after simplifying this, I'll get this equation as minus 0.3024 AX minus 1.3248 AY minus 1.4688 AZ into 10 to the power minus 3 newtons, and then calculate the magnitude. Calculate the magnitude. F is equal to under root of minus 0.3024 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square plus minus 1.3248 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square plus minus 1.4688 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square under root, square root of this. Then I get F is equal to 2.0009 millinewtons. That is the magnitude of the force exerted on a moving charge. with the velocity v. Third example, two long parallel conductors are separated by 2 centimeters in air, carrying a current of 100 ampere flowing in opposite directions. Find the force per meter length of the conductor. So there are two long parallel conductors. They are separated by a distance of 2 centimeters and they are carrying a current of 100 ampere in opposite direction. So this is nothing but a numerical on force on a long parallel conductors. So they are asking us to calculate, find the force per meter length. That means F divided by L I need to calculate. And F divided by L is mu into I1 I2 divided by 2 pi d, where mu value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. In air it is, so mu is equal to mu naught. I'll get 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. I1 and I2 currents are 100 ampere, so 100 into 100 or else 100 square divided by 2 pi d, 2 pi d value is 2 centimeter. That's separated by 2 centimeters. So you will get 2 into 10 to the power minus 2. And substitute all and calculate F by L. So F by L, we will get it as 0.1 Newton per meter is force per meter length of the conductor. Next example, example number 4. The question is, if B is equal to 0.05xAy Tesla in a material for which susceptibility Xm is equal to 2.5, comma, find mu r, mu, h, m, j and jb. J is current density and jb is density for bound charge. So they have given the value of B and Xm and they are asking us to calculate a mu r, mu, h, m, j and jb. So first one, the relative permeability in terms of magnetic susceptibility is given by, we have already seen the equation, that is mu r is equal to Xm plus 1, susceptibility plus 1, so 2.5 plus 1, we will get it as 3.5. Then mu value, that is permeability of the material, is given by mu is equal to mu naught into mu r. Mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. And mu r value, we have already calculated it as 3.5. So I'll get mu value is equal to 4.3982 into 10 to the power minus 6 Henry per meter. Next one, that is I need a H value, field intensity. So first I will calculate a flux density. Formula I will use, that is B is equal to mu into H. And from that I will calculate H because they have given the value of B. So we can write this as B is equal to mu into H, but mu is mu naught into mu r. So from this H is equal to B divided by mu naught into mu r, and the B value is 0.05 AX in AY direction divided by mu naught mu r. We have already calculated as 4.3982 into 10 to the power minus 6. So just simplify this. This term. And we will get it as 11.3682 into 10 to the power 3 x in AY direction ampere per meter. Fourth one is M, that is the magnetization they are asking to calculate the value of M. M is equal to susceptibility into H, that is XM into H. And susceptibility value is 2.5. And H value, we have calculated it as 11.3682 into 10 to the power 3x AY. So that we have to substitute. And we need to multiply with the 2.5 to get the value of magnetization, M. And we will get it as 28.42 into 10 to the power 3x AY ampere per meter. Let us calculate the fifth one, that is J. J is the current density, and we know that J is equal to del cross H. J is equal to del cross H. So we need to find out the cross product del cross H. So I will write AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou y and dou by dou z, and H value is in only which component? AY component. Hence, I'll get a 0 in X as well as 0 in AZ, and AY component is 11.3682 into 10 to the power 3X. So AX as it is, if I take AX as it is, then this into this minus this into this is 0, minus AY as it is, dou by dou X into 0, dou by dou Z into 0 is 0, then AZ into the component, we will get it as AZ into dou by dou X of 11.3682 into 10 to the power 3 X AZ direction. So derivative of X with respect to X is 1. So the term will remain as it is. That is 11.3682 into 10 to the power 3 in AZ direction ampere per meter square. Because it is current density J. Now similarly, I need the value of JB, that is bound current density, and we know that JB is equal to del cross M, where M is magnetization, cross product I need to calculate, and I'll get it as AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z, and M is also which component? AY component. So it is AY component I need to substitute, and remaining AX and AZ components are 0, 0, and for AY component it is 28.42 into 10 to the power 3 X. So again I need to find out the cross product AX as it is into dou by dou Y of 0, dou by dou Z of X component is 0, minus AY of this two term minus this term is 0. Then AZ of dou by dou X of this term. So dou by dou X of this term, derivative of X with respect to X is 1. So I will get the answer as 28.42 into 10 to the power 3 in AZ direction ampere per meter square. And this is the bound current density JB. Let us take the fifth numerical, fifth problem. Then the magnetic flux density in a region of a free space is given by B is equal to minus 3x Ax plus 5 Ay minus 2z Az Tesla. So magnetic flux density in a free region of free space, they have given the value of B. Now the question is to find the total force on the rectangular loop as shown. If it lies in the plane z is equal to 0 and is bounded by x equal to 1, x equal to 3, y equal to 2 and y equal to 5, all the dimensions are in centimeters. So if we see this diagram, we will come to know that there is a rectangular loop, z component is 0, z is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 and 3. And y is equal to 2 and 5. And in the figure they have given, the current value is equal to 30 amp. The current value is 30 amp. And we need to calculate the total force on this rectangular loop. I need to calculate the total force F on the rectangular loop. Now, in the plane z is equal to 0, the z component of the magnetic field B is 0. So that means from the B, we have to take only x and y component always, because z component is 0, because the plane is z is equal to 0, it lies. Then we need to calculate the force on the rectangular loop. So we know the equation as F is equal to, for a closed path, integration of IDL cross B, where I is the current, DL is the element and B is the flux. So let us consider for all the fields So, for numerical, I have considered all the dimension of all the sides are in meter. And then I will calculate x. First one, first slide, first side is 1 to 3. 1 to 3 in centimeter. So, I will write it as 0.01 to 0.03. IDL, I is 30 and DL is, which direction it is? This is in x direction. Hence, I will write it as dx ax. DL I will write it as dx ax, because it is in x direction. I have taken for side 1. Then B value. B value is, for all the B values, we are not considering the Z component. We are considering only the X and Y component, because the plane lies in Z is equal to 0. So X and Y component from B is minus 3X AX plus 5Y AY. So I will write minus 3X AX plus 5Y AY. And IDL is, I is 30 and DL is dx ax, and integration is from 0.01 to 0.03. Now next one, for side 2, that is from, for, let us take from 2 to 5, this side, side 1 is done, this side we have done. Now let us take from 2 to 5, again 2 to 5 means, integration is y tends to from 0.02 to 0.05, and IDL cross B. IDL is, now y value is 30, but DL value is dy ay, because it is in y direction. And V value remains same, minus 3x ax plus 5y AY. Similarly, come to side C, third side. It is integration from 0.32 0.01 this distance. That is again 30x Ax ideal value, B value as it is. And for the last side, it is integration is from 0.052, 0.02, 0.052, 0.02. And it is 30y Ay cross again B value as it is. Let us simplify. For the first one, the cross product is from AX AX as well as AX AY. So we will get it as AX AX is 0 and AX AY we will get it as AZ. Again, AY AX, AZ component AY AY is 0. AX AX is 0, AX AY is AZ component, AY AX is AZ component and AY AY is 0. That means in all the four terms I will get only which component? AZ component. So for the first and the third term I will get plus AZ and for the second and the fourth term I will get minus AZ. So I have simplified this, I have multiplied all, then I will get F is equal to 3 into, that is for the first term, 30 into 5 into 0.02, I will get a 3. Integration is from 0.01 to 0.03 dx az. Similarly, for the second term, I will get 2.7. Third term, I will get 7.5. And for the fourth term, I will get 0.9. And maintain all the terms, that is dx az, dy az, dx az, as well as dy az. So I'll integrate 3 as it is, integration of dx, it is x from 0.01 to 0.03, it is y from 0.02 to 0.05, it is x from 0.03 to 0.01 and it is y from 0.05 to 0.02. Since all are az component, I will simplify all, that is 3 as it is, 0.03 minus 0.01. Plus 2.7 into 0.05 minus 0.02 plus 7.5 0.01 minus 0.03 and plus 0.9 0.02 minus 0.05 and I will simplify this and I will get the answer as minus 0.036 AZ or else minus 36 AZ millinewton. It is the force on the rectangular loop. So force on the rectangular loop is minus 36 AZ millinewton. Now let us see next example, example 6, that is two wires carrying a current in the same directions of 3 ampere, 6 ampere are placed with their axis 5 centimeter apart, free space permeability is equal to 4 pi × 10⁻⁷ Henry per meter. Calculate the force between them in kg per meter length. So here the new concept is I need to represent the force in kg per meter length. So again we know the formula, F is equal to mu I1 I2 into L by 2 pi d. So here I know I1 and I2 are 3 ampere, 6 ampere. L is length of the conductor. Length of the conductor is 4 per unit meter length. That means I need F by L. If they need only force, then they have to give the value of L. But here the question is to calculate force per unit meter length. That means I will get F by L is equal to mu I1 I2 by 2 pi d. Mu value is mu naught into mu r I1 I2 by 2 pi d. And a free space it is, hence mu naught only. Mu r is equal to 1. Current value substitute 3 and 6 divided by 2 pi d. Distance is 5 centimeter apart. So I will get 5 × 10⁻², and calculate F bar L, that is F by L is equal to 72 micro Newton per meter. I'll get this answer as 72 micro Newton per meter. But in the question, they are asking us to express the force in kg per meter. So kg per meter is F by L is equal to 72 × 10⁻⁶, because it is Newton meter, divided by 9.8, because I need to express my F by L in terms of kg per meter. So if I want per kg per meter, if I want to express, then I need to divide it by 9.8. Then I'll get the answer as 7.3469 × 10⁻⁶ kg per meter. So I have expressed the force per length, meter length, in terms of kg per meter as this. Now let us take the seventh example, a numerical on reluctance in magnetic circuits. Now the question is, a magnetic circuit comprising a toroid with a 500 turns, cross-sectional area of 6 cm square and mean radius 15 cm, carries a current of 4 ampere. Find the reluctance for the magnetic circuit and total flux enclosed. So I need to calculate the reluctance, yes, and the total flux, phi. So we know the formula for reluctance as S is equal to 2 pi r divided by mu a, that is L divided by mu a, where L is equal to 2 pi r. And flux, total flux, phi is equal to, I know the formula, phi is equal to B into A, where A is the area, L value is 2 pi r, where r is the mean radius, and S is the reluctance. So S is equal to 2 pi r divided by mu naught into A. So 2 pi r as it is, r value is 15 centimeter. Hence I will get it as 15 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by mu naught A. Mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and A value, that is area, is 6 centimeter square, that is 6 into 10 to the power minus 4. So this is the numerical on magnetic circuit of toroidal coil. So from this I will get the value of S is equal to 1.25 into 10 to the power 9. I will get the value S. Then I need to calculate the flux, that is phi is equal to BA, where A is the area and B value is, what is the value of B? Mu naught Ni divided by 2 pi r. It is the value of B, that is the magnetic flux density inside the turns of the toroid is given by B is equal to mu naught Ni divided by 2 pi r, where N represents the number of turns, I represents the current, and R represents the radius. So I will substitute, that is phi is equal to BA. B value is mu naught Ni divided by 2 pi r into A. That is equal to, I will write mu naught by L, because L is 2 pi r. Mu naught A by 2 pi r, that is L. And remaining term N into I will separately write, because mu naught A by L, I can replace it as 1 divided by S, that is reluctance, because S is equal to 2 pi r divided by mu naught A. So I will get mu naught A by L into Ni, and mu naught A by L, I will replace it as 1 divided by S. Hence the flux phi is equal to Ni divided by S. So I will substitute the value of N. That is, N is equal to 500, current I is 4 amps, N is 5, current I is 4 amps, and S value, I have calculated the value of S, 1.25 to 10 to the power 9, and I will substitute this and I will calculate the value of phi as 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 6. Example 8. Let us see next example. Find the torque vector on a square loop having corners. They have given four corners. This is the corner. And I need to calculate the torque. First one is about the origin. About the origin I need to calculate by B is equal to 0.4 AX Tesla. And second one is about the origin by B is equal to 0.6 AX minus 0.4 AY Tesla. So I need to calculate the torque vector. First one is by considering B is equal to 0.4 AX. And second one is by considering B is equal to 0.6 AX minus 0.4 AY. So this is the loop. It is placed in this corner. So what is the total area of the loop? Is it not area of the loop? From this figure, since it is in placed in X and Y, I will get the component in Z direction as, so this value, Z component is 0 everywhere, only x and y component, that is -2, -2, 2, 2, and -2, 2, 2, -2. Hence, I will get area as 4 × 4, that is 16 az component. Az is the unit vector along z direction. Hence, the total area of the loop, how much is the area? Since everywhere it is a constant 2 in x and y component, hence the unit vector along the z axis, az direction, is given by 16 az will be the area of the loop. Then I need to calculate the torque. I know the equation for the torque, T is equal to I into A cross B, where A is the area and B is the magnetic field. And I is the current. So, the current value is 0.5 amps. They have given current as 0.5 amps. And let us take the first case as about the origin by B is equal to 0.4 AX. So I will use the formula T is equal to I into A cross B. Substitute all the values. I is equal to 0.5. A value is 16 AZ that I have calculated, cross B value. B value is 0.4 AX. That is AZ cross AX, I will get it as AY component. And the values are 0.4, 16, and 0.5, 0.5, 16, and 0.4. If I multiply all, I will get this as 3.2 into AY component, Newton meter. It is torque T. So for the first case, it is 3.2 AY component, Newton meter. Similarly, you can do for case 2. That is to find the torque about the origin by B value. B value is changed now. For the second case, it is 0.6 AX minus 0.4 AY. Tesla B value, substitute the B value, that is current I into A cross B, A value remains same, 16 AZ, and B value is 0.6 AX minus 0.4 AY, and again here AZ AX and AZ AY. So I will get the final answer, torque as 3.2 AX plus 4.8 AY. So the total torque is 3.2 AX plus 4.8 AY, unit is Newton meter. So this is how we will do. We have done the simple numericals along with the solutions on unit 4. Thank you all. Thank you.